Good afternoon. Welcome to the yoga room. Today we will continue what we began on Tuesday, getting ready for the solstice, which is March 21st. So only two times in the year does the sun reach a perfect balance, and then it begins to tilt to more light, or it tilts to more darkness, depending on whether you're in the northern or southern hemisphere. Here in the northern hemisphere, we're tilting towards more light and warmer weather. So in the yoga body, this is the sun chakra right here. And I have kind of a ball today to show you right here, okay? And the top is our diaphragm. So it's the diaphragm belt. So we're going to access this part of our body again today by keeping it open rather than crushing it, okay, or pushing it out, but keeping it floating in the center of our body. So we're going to start out on the chair. If you want to be on the floor, this is beautiful on the floor, flat on your back, with your knees bent and your feet standing, and breathe. Inhale and feel your inhale in your belly. You can inhale and pull in, but no, that raises anxiety. Okay, so inhale and let the belly expand. Exhale, you feel the belly move back. Inhale. And exhale. Keeping that breath in mind, that moving in and out of the lower body, lift the spine, and that's where the bottom of your sun is sitting. The top of your sun is up here. Okay. So a nice big warm yellow ball right in this part of your body. And let's breathe together, just letting this expand. And paying a visit. Okay, to begin, roll your shoulders. And swing. If you're on the floor, I guess you have to get on your knees to do this. Okay. Keeping this wide. We're going to do Janu Shirshasana on the floor, but for anybody who is restricted in their chair, let me just give you the two poses or the two ways to participate. So when we bring in the right knee, when we're on the floor, you could move towards the front of your chair, bend your right knee, and put the belt on your left foot. Okay? That's opening. And then, of course, we'll go the other way. So if you're on the chair, that's how you do today's mini lesson. And we'll also move our knees at the end of the class, so you can do it like this on the chair. Everybody else, if you're not chair restricted, let's get down on the floor. If you have your blanket. You can sit on your blanket. The tighter your hamstrings, the higher you fold your blanket. Okay, and let's just start with the legs open. Okay, and wiggle the feet. And of course, we're paying attention to what is happening here as you wiggle your feet, not crushing your sun. Oh, here's the sun I used the other day. Okay, so wiggle the feet. getting this open. It's kind of a dark day here today. So. And then let's reach under our right knee, pull that knee up, turn the foot to the inside of the left upper thigh. If you need a prop underneath, you can put a block underneath your knee, or you can slide a pillow underneath there, okay? And just lengthen, pushing your hands down, lengthen. So there's a slight pelvic tilt. Attach your arms to the back body by squeezing the upper back slightly. Okay, and we're gonna start by taking your left hand on the outside of that right knee and turning your sun slightly to the right. You can think of it as to the east. Okay, so just turning your sun. So you're not turning your nose, you're turning your sun. And lengthen the torso. And then come back to the center. And now we're going to put our right hand on the inside of the right knee and turn the sun to the west or to the left. Okay, so go back and forth. And let's go once more to the right. And now, taking your belt around the metatarsal on your left foot, as if you're riding the sun chariot, okay? So here's your sun. The sun is facing the big toe of your left foot, and you're pulling back on the horses, so to say, as you lengthen your spine. Dropping the sit bone, expanding here. And then, now bringing the nose towards the big toe and the sun towards the front of the top of the left thigh. You may not come down far, so we don't want you to crush the sun. So keep the sun big, and also you have sun in the back body. Be aware of the sun spreading all through the middle of your body, balancing the top and the bottom, okay? Just like the equinox. Lengthen the spine. Let this whole area be big, big in the back, big on the sides. And then come on up. And we're going to lengthen that right foot again, give it a wiggle, lift up behind the knee of the left leg, put the left foot, the sole of the left foot on the upper right inside thigh. You can put the block under your knee if you like. And again, if you're on the chair, I gave instructions for the chair early. So just open up here, nice and wide, nice and bright, and stretch up. Stretch sideways, attach your arms to the back body, and we're going to begin by taking the right hand on the outside of the left knee and turning our sun to the left. Lengthening the spine, keeping this whole area open. Best you can do. Even if you think that it's open, that's excellent. That you can bring your attention there and feel that it's open. Even if it isn't, that's the way to go. Come forward, and now we're going to take our left hand on the inside of our left knee and turn our sun to the right. Again, this is where we're keeping open. and putting our body proprioception, dividing the top from the bottom and the middle part big. Come back to the center, walk up there, repeat, come back. We're going to go this direction again, so right hand and turn. Again, imagine this is really big and bright. And turn this way. Putting the belt around the right metatarsal. Get ready to ride the chariot. Pull on the straps and lengthen the middle body. Now moving the nose towards the big toe and your sun towards the top of your thigh, come forward. Best you can do. It could be half an inch, it could be a quarter inch, it could be 2 inches. Keeping all of this big. It's a nice stretch too for the kidney. And in the chair, you can do this. Okay, and then come upright. Now, in the chair, you can hold the side of your chair and lift your heart. For those of us on the mat, you're going to take your block. Okay, first, flatten out and just roll your hip from side to side, keeping the shoulders stable. And let's take our block, put it underneath the pelvis. You can use the medium or low. Widen the shoulders. And we're going to take our sun chakra here, our sun part of our body, and shine it up towards the sky, and also shine it down towards the center of the earth. Okay, so let's do that together. Press the feet down, turn the palms up, widen. Widen, lift up, lift down. And breathe into the bottom of the belly, below the navel. Relaxing, inviting the jaw to relax. And you can put your hand on your belly and feel the belly lift and drop as you breathe. Gently. Then just take the block, move it aside, put your shins parallel to the ceiling, and just move from from the right hip to the left hip, keeping the shoulders flat and keeping big here. You may go just an inch or 2 inches side to side. So we're dividing the top from the bottom with the sun in the middle. And when you're ready, roll to your side. Come on up. We can sit and breathe together. Bringing some balance into our bodies, into our families, into our hearts. So let's inhale for four, exhale for four, doing the heart breath, heart being the nostril. So breathing into the heart, exhaling from the heart, dropping the mind into the heart. We're warming the heart from below. So exhale, inhale. One, two, three, four. Exhale, one, two, three, four. Inhale, one, two, three, four. Exhale, one, two, three, four. Inhale, one, two, three, four. Exhale, one, two, three, four. And one more time, nice and gentle. Inhale, one, two, three, four, and exhale, one, two, three, four. And let's just hold our hearts, pay attention to our hearts, continue to breathe through your heart. And let's take this warm solstice energy and the energy from the heart and just blow it out into the world. And I will see you next week. So the solstice is on the 21st. So that's Saturday here in Eastern Standard Time. I think the perfect moment is early in the morning, the perfect balance moment. So check you can Google it, I'm sure. Okay. Thank you. Bye-bye.